Hello dear students, welcome to the transmission and distribution class. In the previous classes, we are seeing how a typical transmission scheme is working, starting from the generating station till end user, the different classifications or different things we are made, that is generating station, primary transmission, secondary transmission, primary distribution and secondary distribution, as well as the different feeders, all those things we have seen. Now we will see the DC transmission. So as I told you, a transmission can be classified into either DC transmission or AC transmission depending upon the way or method we are adopting. First we will see the DC transmission. What are the advantages of this DC transmission? So the comparison can be done with the both advantages and disadvantages of the DC transmission as well as AC transmission. So you can write the comparison later. What are the advantages of the DC transmission? See, it requires only two conductors as compared to AC. There is a three transmission line. As we know that the AC, there is a three phases RYB. We require the three wires. Coming to here, DC requires only two conductors, plus and minus. So there is no inductance, capacitance and phase displacement and surge problems in the DC transmission. If it is AC, there is a frequency present. Because of the frequency, inductance, capacitance will be there. But in DC, there is a frequency zero. So these effects are not there. Due to the absence of the inductance, voltage drop of the DC transmission line is very less compared to the AC line. The same load and the same end voltage. For this reason, the DC transmission line has better voltage regulation. The same voltage and the same power, if you are having the AC will there is also effect of inductance and reactive drop will be there. Because of that, voltage regulation is poor compared to the same voltage DC. There is no skin effect in the DC system. Therefore, entire cross section of the conductor is utilized. In AC systems, the charges are concentrating at the boundary. So only the boundary area is utilized, that is called a skin effect. In that is there in the AC system, but in the DC system, that problem is not there. That's why total area of the conductor is utilized. And next, for the same working voltage, the potential stress on the insulation is less in case of DC. The same voltage in AC, there will be having more stress. So DC line requires the less insulation compared to the AC line. A DC line has a less corona loss and reduced interference with the communication circuits. High voltage of DC transmission is free from the dielectric losses, particularly in case of cables. And in DC transmission, there are no stability problems and synchronizing difficulties. If it is AC, means there is a need to synchronize two or more generators are there, means there is a problem of synchronization. But in DC, such things are not there. Oh, then coming to the disadvantages of the DC transmission, electric power cannot be generated at high voltage due to the commutation problems. Commutation is a big problem in DC system. Because of this, we cannot go for the high voltage AC, DC generation. But AC, we can go for the high voltage AC generation. The DC voltage cannot be stepped up or stepped down easily, so it is not at all possible, because we are not having the DC transformers, because transformers are working on its frequency. Coming to DC, there is no frequency, so no transformers are there for DC things. So we cannot go for step up and step down in the voltages. The DC switches and circuit breakers have their own limitations, as well as it is costlier than the AC equipments. Coming to the AC transmission, what is the advantages? The major disadvantages of the DC system is nothing but the advantages in the AC system. And major advantages of the DC system is the disadvantages in the AC system. We can see here, advantages are power can be generated at high voltages. At any voltages we can generate, because there is no commutation problems here. The maintenance of AC substation is easy and cheaper. As I told you, the costlier equipment in the DC, in AC it is very cheaper. Means very cheaper means comparatively it is cheaper than the DC. The AC voltage can be stepped up or stepped down by the transformers with ease and efficiency. This permits the transmit power at high voltages and distribute at the safe potential. So it is the one of the major advantages that you can step up or step down to your required voltage level in case of your AC system. But this is not possible in your DC. Coming to the disadvantages of the AC, an AC line requires more copper. As you know, AC line requires 3 wires, means DC is only 2 wires. That's what more copper is required. Construction of AC transmission lines is more complicated than the DC transmission line because we need to take the different effects of AC system. That's why it is a little bit complication. Due to skin effect, the effective resistance of the line is increased. Only the surface is used in the AC system. That's why as area is less there, then resistance is more. So resistance is increasing because of the virtual area. And AC line has capacitance, therefore there is a continuous loss of the power due to charging current. So because of the capacitance present in the line, so there is a always charging current, that is a losses which takes place in the AC system. So we can see here, this is the single line diagram of the DC transmission, where a generating station is there. From that generating station, we are having a sending end transformer. The generated AC is step up to the higher voltages. Then there is a mercury arc rectifier. Using mercury arc rectifier, it is converted to DC. Once it is converted to DC, it is transmitted with the DC lines. At the receiving end, there will be thyristor, which is nothing but it's a like an inverter which is going to convert DC to AC. When it is inverting back to AC, the receiving end transformer is there, that is that will be going to make the required voltage level, and once again it is taken as three phase AC. So while DC transmission system is considered, we required a mercury arc rectifier, we required thyristors, so two different transformers. So only thing is, what in between we will save in the copper, but you may require the two additional equipments like mercury arc rectifier as well as thyristor to rectify the AC to DC, and once again inverting back from DC to AC. So this is what the single line diagram of a high voltage DC transmission. So as we have seen here, the DC transmission advantages and disadvantages, you see in the AC transmission's advantages and disadvantages, and the single line diagram of the DC transmission. And in the next class, we will going to see the what is the advantages of going for the high voltage. So if you got any doubts in these things, you can contact me in our WhatsApp group. Stay home, stay safe. Thank you.